All right. Time to test the HM-01. We got the ignition wired up. We checked the timing earlier. I'm going to try using this fuel tank again, see how that works. I've got plenty of oil. It's a little light on compression, so I'm hoping that it works. I mean, you can hear it there, so hopefully it will pick up with a little bit of running in. So let me move the setup and get ready, and then we'll try this out. All right. I plugged the trigger in on the ignition here, and we'll get our spark plug wire on there. Turn the fuel on, plug it in, add oil to these oil cups on the main bearings. And make sure I get plenty of oil around the bottom end and everywhere else. Especially on a first run after the assembly, because everything was pretty dry. Even though I put oil in it and made sure it was well oiled as I assembled it, I want to make sure that you get plenty of oil on everything. Now, that needle is closed, so we'll try giving it a quarter turn. Fuel up the line, so let's open the needle valve until the fuel flows. And I'm going to flip the lever in to hold the detent open. That way, if I turn it too fast while it's starting. Oh. Clamp in a good spot here. is a chilly day out. Oh, I think I felt it pop there. Let's do it another spin or two. I need a better way to hold this down. I smell fuel, so... I think I saw a puff, so it's... There we go. I got it super flooded. Alright, I think we're flooding. I do like this knob has a clicker on the knurling, so it's easy to partially adjust it. Time to unhook the ignition. See if I got this flooded out really badly. Yep. Managed to flood it out. Now that we've dried the plug, Thank you. All right. Well, it's a bit chilly out. It is popping and firing a little bit. This fuel tank is really tall, so I suspect that it's, when I open the valve, it's just dumping fuel in. So if it's not running when I turn the valve, it floods out really quick. So might actually be close. Let's try adjusting this notch by notch. Well, I can smell the fuel again, so it must be flooded. I'm gonna give up on this. It popped and wheezed a little bit, but it's a chilly day. I also want to double check the valve clearance here on the tappet. I used that spacer that they provided, but I may open that gap a little bit just to delay the valve opening a teeny bit. And yeah, I might try this again with this big purple fuel tank, but, I may also just not have any luck until I have the smaller tank, cause this one, like I said, is tall, so it's providing positive pressure on the needle there. So if I don't get it just right, it will flood out really easily. But, yeah, between it being a cold day and not having a very good setup to test this, I'm going to go in and look at it again and double-check some things. Yeah, it's gotten better compression as I spun it, so working it in a little bit definitely helped, but I can still hear there's blow-by on the valves or someplace. I can hear it wheezing, so we'll check that out too and see if we can get a little bit tighter fit there. So yeah, we'll do some tuning and see if we can get this to start, but it doesn't look like it'll do it today.